Yes, hello, good morning student. Myself Elja, I am standing before you to teach mathematics of class 10. And chapter is continued and it is my fourth lecture and I am doing the exercise 5.2. I have previously completed up to the question number 7. Now I have to do the question number 9. In the 9, the question is in this way. I am reading the question. Question is if the third term and the ninth term of AP is 4 and minus 8 respectively, find respectively which term of the AP is 0. Accordingly, the question number 7, same way, according to the question number 7, we have to solve. As I have done in the question number 7, same way question number 9 is there. Here the question is given that the third term and the ninth term of an AP is 4 and minus 8 respectively. Which term of the AP will be 0? Let first term of an AP equal to A. Common difference equal to D. Therefore, third term equal to A plus 3 minus 1 into D. This is given that A plus 2D equal to what? 4. This is a first equation. First equation is given. And T ninth term A plus 9 minus 1 into D. Therefore, A plus 8D, this is given that minus 8. This is the second equation. On solving equation 1 and 2, A plus 2D, A plus 2D equal to 4 and A plus 8D equal to minus 8. Then minus, this will be the plus, this will be cancel out. 8D minus 8D plus 2D minus 6D equal to 8 plus 4, 12. Therefore, D equal to 12 by minus 6 equal to D equal to minus 2. D is a minus 2. Then we can find the first term putting the value of D equal to minus 2. Then A plus 2 into minus 2 equal to 4. A equal to 4 plus 4. This will be the 8. A is 8, D is a minus 2. Therefore, we can find hence which term is a 0? Which term will be 0? Let Tn term is a 0. Tn term is a 0. The Tn term equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. Tn term is a 0. Therefore, A is a 8 plus n n, we have to find the value of n, n into d is a minus 2 already I have find there. This will come this side, minus 8 equal to minus 2 into n minus 1, minus minus get cancelled to 4, n minus 1, n minus 1, n minus 4 equal to n minus 1, therefore n equal to 4 plus 1 means 5th term is 0. Fifth term is a 0. Next, after this we have to solve. I have taken after 2 or 3 more sums from these chapters. I have taken 13 number question. After the 9, 3 questions I am leaving for you to solve as homework. After that, different types of the sum I am taking from the exercise. Question number 13. Now I am solving the question number 13. The question number 9, we have to do the question number 13. See how I am solving the question number 13. It is completely different from the two above sum. Question number 13 is in this way, that question number 13 is how many 3-digit numbers are divisible by 7. 3-digit number, dear students, we know that the 3-digit number is starting from the 100, but 100 is not divisible by 7. The first divisible by 7, how you will find that divisible by 7, 100, and you will divide 7 1 ja 7 and 3 and 0 and 35, 5 7 ja 35, therefore 105 is the first number of the 3 digit that is divisible by 7. And after that we have to proceed more numbers by adding 7, 112, after the 112, then there will be 119, and after that 126 in this way, so on. Here the question is how many 3-digit numbers are divisible, and last is a 3, largest 3-digit number is a 999, but it is whether it is divisible by 7 or not we don't know, so we have to check it by dividing 7. Only we have to take those numbers which is divisible by 7. 7 1 ja 7 2 9 7 2 is 14, 5 will be subtracted, therefore 994, the last digit will be 994. Here how many 3 digit, if you will count 1 2 3 4, and which position 994 will occupy we don't know. We can find with the help of the formula. This is the TN term and this is the first term, and the common difference is also given that is a 7. Therefore, first we have to write A equal to 105, and D is 7, and TN term is 994. Therefore, TN term equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. TN term is given that 994 a is 105 plus and n is a not known, that is required n minus 1, and d is a 7. First we have to this transpositions here is required, then 994 minus 105 equal to n minus 1 into d means 7. Therefore 4, 14 minus 9, 8 minus 0, 8, and 9 minus 1, this is 8, n minus 1 into 7. Therefore, n minus 1 equal to 8, 8, 9 by 7. 7 1 7. 7 1 ja 7, 7 2 ja 14, and 7 7 ja 29. Therefore, n minus 1 equal to 127. Therefore, n minus 1 equal to 127, or n equal to 128. Hence, the number of the terms, therefore, how many? Three digits number, therefore, three digits number which is divisible by 7 is 128. In this way we can find. After that 13 number, I am leaving two questions for you, 14, 15, and then I have taken 16 number. 16 number question. We have to solve the 16 number question. 16 number question just which is also from the AP, and question is just same way, somewhat different from this, and according to the formula and the rules we can find this sum also. Always we have to apply the formula. Without formula no sum can be solved. Here see what is the statement in the question number 16. Determine the AP whose third term requirement, what is the requirement? AP, we have to frame the AP in which third term is 16 and seventh term exceeds the fifth term by 12. Let first term equal to a common difference equal to d, common difference d. Therefore in the first situation third term is a 16, t3 equal to a plus 3 minus 1 into d, or a plus 2d equal to 16, it is given that. And after that the seventh term t7th, as the instruction is given in the questions we have to follow, t7 term a plus 7 minus 1 into d, a plus 6d, this is also second. And after that the fifth term T5, a plus 5 minus 1 into d, a plus 4d. Therefore, this is the third. Here the relationship between the T7 and T5th is given that T7th term exceed the T5th term by 12. According to the question, T7 minus T5 equal to 12, it is given that. We have to put the value. T7 is A plus 6D minus A plus 4D equal to 12. It is given that. Now, A plus 6D minus A minus 4D equal to 12. A cancel and 6 minus 4D, 2D equal to 12. Therefore, 2, 6. This D equal to 6. Here we have find the D. D is obtained by placing the value of D in the equation. First, we will get the value of A. Putting the value of D equal to 6, D equal to 6 in equation 1. A plus 2 into 6 equal to 16, or A equal to 16 minus 6 to the 12, this will be the A, 16 minus 12, this will be 4. Here A is a 4, D is a 6, therefore required AP equal to A is a 4, 4 plus 6, 10, 10 plus 6, 16, 16 plus 6, 22, so on. In this way, we can frame the AP. This is the requirement. After the 16, I have no question leave. Immediate, I have taken the 17 number because it is a completely different type. So, I have solved the 17 number question. After the 16, I have taken the 16 number sum. See how I have solved in this way. You have to solve if you are trying the different types of the sum from the R.S. Agarwal. R.S. Agarwal having the lots of the sum, same types, 4-5 questions are same way. So, if you want to have more practice, then you can also use the R.S. Agarwal book other than the NCERT book. But NCERT book is the CBSC prescribed book, so it will be the better to first do the good practice. You have must good practice in the NCERT book, then and increase your practice, you can also go through the R.S. Agarwal book. That will be the better, because these days is the day of the competition. If you have the tremendous knowledge about in the particular chapter or subjects, then you can face, otherwise you will lagging behind in the competitive exam. So you go much more sums and of the different types of the book other than the NCERT. But for the view of the examination and CBSE examinations, concentrate on the NCERT book also in first priority. Now I am solving the 17 number. Question number 17. Question number 17 is in this way, find the 20th term. T20 is a requirement. What will be the T20th term? From the last, I have given the formula. From the last, the AP is given. AP is in this way, 3, 8, 13, so on, 253. From the last term is given that 253. First term is a 3, common difference CD is a means 5. Therefore, nth term, the formula I have written on the blackboard, nth term from the last equal to L minus N minus 1 into D. Therefore, L is the last term, 200, 253, and the value of N, 20th term is required, 20 minus 1, D is a 5. Therefore, 253 minus 20 minus 1, 19 into 5, 253 minus 95. Therefore, 8 and 158. Therefore, you can state 158 is the 20th term from the last of the given a piece. Okay, after that we have leave one question for you, 18 number, and then I have solved the 19. The number of question in this chapter is 20. One more questions I have taken. After that I will move for the next exercise. Now question number 19. Question 19 last sum from this exercise. Subha Roy started work in 1995 at an annual salary of rupees 5000 and received an increment of 200 rupees each year. In which year did his income reach to 7000? Means someone started the job, and that is the year 1995 year. In 1995 someone started the job with the salary how much? 5000. And the next year the salary increased to 5200 and the next 5400 in this way, and it reached to the 7000. In the question, in which year did his income, means after how many years the salary of that person will be up to the 7000. Therefore, first A is here, according to the question A, first term is a 5000. After that, common difference CD is a 200 each year, the increment is a 200, and TN term is a 7000. Therefore, according to the formula, we have to put all the value. TN term equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. TN term is a 7000 and A is a 5000 plus N is a requirement, number of the years, N minus 1 into D is a 200. First we have to do the transposition. 5000 will come this side and this will give the 2000 equal to n minus 1 into 200. 200 will come this side, then n minus 1 equal to 2000 by 200. 200, 0, 0 cancel and 2, 10. 10. Therefore, n minus 1 equal to 10, or n equal to 10 plus 1 equal to 11 years. In the 11 years, the salary of the people means Subha Rai will be 7000 in the 11th year. Therefore, in 11th year, salary will be 7000 rupees. 7000. After completing the question number 19, in the next class, in the fifth lecture, I will solve the exercise will be the 5.3. Thank you. Have a nice day.